The Bakery Run, we're back. All the political stuff's out of the way. It's about the people show. So we've got, let's go, Just the Girl Who Eats with 3 Z's is in there. And also 8-7, Yoshia Aki, 5-6-7 have said, there's right down there. They're like, hey, you need to go to this place in Ellerslie. We're here at Richon Patisserie. I don't know if that's, I don't know, I'm not French. I don't know that stuff. I'm just ready to get some pies, man. Okay, and I've got another person that has recommended this bakery, and he can knock yous all out, straight up. All right, let's go.
All right.
It's busy, it's a busy spot.
It is. All right, so this is your spot, eh, brother?
Yeah.
Okay, when's the first time that you came here and you realized this is the spot?
Well, I actually opened my gym around the corner in Ellerslie. Yep. So this is why I come here every day, every couple of days.
So what's the go-to for you, brother?
For me?
Yeah,
the pies. I go just a steak and cheese.
I was actually gonna say about this one, bro. Duck and creamy mushroom. But, bro, Dan Hooker doesn't duck anyone, bro. Fucking let's go. He's allergic to duck. He never ducks.
Okay. What's up, how are you?
So,
yeah, good, brother.
So bro, you're not a sweet guy.
I'm not a sweet tooth.
No?
Nah, if I'm being honest, I'm a savory man myself.
Okay. So we got an option here. I mean, it's on you, brother. We can go two
it's
of these.
Me.
We can go two of these.
Yeah, we'll go a couple of pies.
Okay, let's go, eh?
I grab two steak and cheese.
Two steak and cheese, yeah.
And then you pick the next one.
Okay.
Because even...
Bro, this is my fucking
chicken,
show, bro.
Chicken camembert is pretty good.
Oh, okay, we'll go to the chicken camembert.
What are you after?
Bro, I'll go with the Mountain Dew, bro. Is that alright? Okay. Oh, is this your. Is that alright, bro?
Shit.
I'll sort it out, bro. I've got this, bro. Don't worry. You haven't had a fight for a while, bro. You haven't had a fight for a while, alright? I got you.
I will soon. Right,
don't worry.
Just 20 bucks.
Cheers.
One cookie, red curry.
Oh, Dan, bro. Dan, it declined, brother. Oh, it declined. Can you
get. No, I'll get you, bro. I'll get you.
Brother. Sorry, bro.
Thank you, boss.
Isn't that knife and fork?
Knife and fork?
Nah.
We're all right with that, brother. Okay. So this is your local, bro. How long have you been here since you had a...
Yeah, well, I moved back to New Zealand. Did like a little bit of personal training for probably like 6 months. And then one of the guys I was coaching asked me if I wanted to start a gym.
Yo.
So we got a space around the corner. And so this, like, since that, I got like quite involved in like the Ellerslie community. Like you're over here every day.
Okay.
It's like we're all just gym rats. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like you just train, hang out, and then just hanging around waiting for the next training session.
How dope
so
is
we
that
come down right? here, we get used to all the local spots. I really like Ellerslie, so then I've even bought a house around the corner. So yeah. I'm part of the community for good.
Because did you grow up with Mount Albert, Mags, right?
I went to Mags. Yeah, high school, but I grew up mainly in Mount Ross School.
All right, man, let's get into it. That one is the steak and cheese, your steak and cheese.
Let's go have a bite, see what
wait. We need to, are we putting this on the top? Are you the person that puts it under? Or how do you use your tea sauce, bro?
I kind of use it as lubricant, you know what I mean?
Oh.
When I need it, I'll apply it as I need. I'll come in here, I'll get a good bite going. I've got to start the show, you know.
So
do
you get the bite and then you just put it in there, bro? You put the lubrication in
after. Then I'll catch the edges.
Oh, bro, the fucking science of the man. You're the Eugene Behrman of fucking pies, brother.
Well, I gotta have a good bite and then evaluate.
Okay, let's have
if I have a good bite, then I have like a starting point and I know to evaluate how much sauce that I'll need.
Okay, all right, bro, here we go, bro. Ooh.
Get a bit on the edges.
So this is, let's get a close up of this, everyone. Oh,
let's get a bit on the edges.
Oh,
and even it out.
Fucking scientific, bro. I'm gonna try this now, bro. We need a name for this. So on each of the edges.
Just gotta play it by ear, you know. Gotta adapt.
If I say, oh, this is a fucking amazing fruit pie. Everyone in the comments gonna go, drop your nuts, bro. Drop your nuts to Dan Hooker, bro. But I'm not even dropping my nuts. This is a very good pie. Like, I'm impressed with how much cheese is in there. Yeah. Holy heck.
I don't know what
they're doing. These dudes know what they're up to. But it's a 10-8 round. This is not a 10-8 round, bro. This is a, where would you go on this?
Where are we going out of?
Out of 10?
10.
is this 10 for you?
I'm going 10. Okay.
Again, bro, if I say anything less than a 10, I'm getting choked the fuck out, bro. Okay? No, I'm actually like legit though. This is up there. Like I just like the cheese, man. Like look at the content of the cheese. I noticed like even the gravy's
meat.
Quite
a bit of meat in there.
Yeah, and the gravy's like not jelly, it's nice.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go with a 10 too. I'm gonna go with a 10. All right, and then maybe when you're off camera, I'll give the real one. No, it's really good. It's really good.
I said my editor at the end.
Be like, bro, let's come back, bro. I'll come to your bakery then. When you finish coming off the weight cuts, and you know everything's good, finish the, I don't know, what is the process there? Can you eat straight away or nah? Like after you weigh in, you just go for it or what?
Nah. It's not till after fight where you can really take the piss. Like, seen a lot of guys like, yeah, like you gotta put the right foods back into your body.
Yep.
So it's like, people think that, and I used to think it when I was like younger. I've done like the dumbest things you could possibly imagine. I've done every single one
okay,
of them
what are
in terms of fighting, like coming off the scale and then just eating like a whole pizza. And just thinking that that was like just having stomach cramps for like a day and a half.
Yeah, because your body is.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Like right? Your body just goes into absolute shock.
Yeah.
So I've like been through all of that. Now I like live like a pretty like well balanced lifestyle.
Okay.
Like I used to do, you know, weight cuts, like clean your diet up for 10, 12 weeks, lose heaps of weight, and then just chuck it all back on after the fight. Eat everything in sight. And yeah. It's just not, you do it when you're young, but it's just not like a healthy way to live. Like it mucks up your hormones and stuff like that. Now I'm like, I just keep it like 80-20, like 80% good and then 20% of the time, like you can eat out, have some McDonald's, like have a pie, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So then after a fight, you don't just feel like stuffing your face in and
yeah.
Making a meal of yourself, just keeping like well balanced year round.
All right, let's get into this next pie, eh? All right, here we go.
Back in order.
This is good. Even the, you know, sometimes when you have cranberry and it's like, too much fruit. Mm. This is not like that. It's just enough. Because that's the last thing you want us to eat and it tastes like fucking one of those apple pies from McDonald's. You know what I mean? This is fucking on.
You go first.
I was going to go first because I think we're...
Yeah, you know, I went first last time.
We've kind of broke the mold here. In whatever I say, you know, we're friends now. We can't get... Nah. Oh shit, that's a camembert though. Because camembert is expensive as hell, bro. I'm gonna lift mine up to a 9. When was that a 9? An 8? It's going up to a 9. Now, this is your test now. Are you bringing it up to a 9.5 here, Dan?
I'll meet you. I'll meet you at a 9.
You want to match it up?
Yeah, I'll meet you at a 9.
All right. With that respect thing, with respect is earned, is there anybody in the UFC that you were kind of like, you know, like the, what's the word? The mask they put on, you know, sometimes. And then you see them in real life, you're like, fuck, that wasn't actually who you were. Because I found that was Strickland, eh? When I was over there, he was like, how are you?
I've met Strickland a bunch of times.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden it's like, boom.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
he's selling the fight,
good.
Right?
No, he's pretty good.
Yeah, he's a good
like,
dude.
In terms of it, like, he's like pretty chill. You can pick it, you know what I mean? It's like the cold, it's the guys that talk a bunch of shit and you never seen him. Mm. They're the ones that are like just doing like a fake one, you know what
yeah.
I mean? Like a Colby Covington or Cejudo or something like that. Like where they'll say one thing, and then you'll like never actually catch the guy. Whereas like Strickland will talk to shit, but then he like walks around with everyone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Me too, like I'll say what's on my mind. I'll be like completely honest, but I'm not like hiding in a back room, staying away from, like if anyone actually had a problem with me, like I'm not like a difficult person.
Yeah. I mean, we got a hold of you.
I'm not like a real difficult person to track down.
Yeah.
Because it's like.
Yeah, it's fucking weird, eh? Like he was great, but yeah, you could see it was like, cameras on, boom. I was thinking about it, eh? I was like, fuck, bro, there's some fights that are like Dan Hooker versus such and such would be fucking on, like someone like Chris Lieben and fucking Vanderlei and just fucking those dudes that just stand in the middle and just go for it.
That bang was, man, he wants me to bring the bang man back.
Yeah, but the bang man nigga never left.
He's always there. I just gotta keep
just takes there. A head fucking
he's
kick there. From old fucking
he's there. He's there when I need him.
Bro, that head kick that you took in your last fight, bro. I was like, oh shit, he's woken up, bro. You look like you were like, okay, let's fucking
go
now.
Yeah, I was like, oh yeah.
Oh yeah, took it. Here we go. Doing that walk. Like when's the like cause it must be fucking scary, G. I'm not even gonna lie. Like there must be some element of fuck. But you get over that as the more. When did it start getting like, oh yeah, it's just the everyday thing now. I just this walk isn't as scary as it was in my first fight?
I'd say when you first, it's just such a big learning curve.
Yeah.
Every fight, you just get more and more used to it. But now after so many, there's nothing I love more in the world than doing it. That's why the COVID one sucks so bad.
How was that, bro?
It was bad. I fought Poirier. That was one of the first.
That's the best fight. One of the first fights.
Absolutely, no adrenaline. I remember just walking out and I was standing there, my music's on. I was looking around the room, I count 15 people. I was I stink.
This is the shit.
It was the worst. I had absolutely no adrenaline for that fight. And then when we finally got back to fans, and that was it. I remember standing out back, and because you can hear the roar of the whole stadium back, and it was rumbling. Ooh. I get to the edge and then the cameras, and then everyone's starts screaming at you, you know what I mean? Man,
yeah.
And I was just standing, this is it. I was going, this is it, this is it. That's the best feeling in the world. I love walking out in there, fighting in front of everyone. If you take the crowd out of it, I'm just...
It's just having a more serious spar, right?
It's just sparring where I have to go to hospital after.
But anyway, brother, thank you so much, my bro. Kind of appreciate you, brother. Shit.